Okay. So what's about me? I'm an idealist. My condition. I'm an innovator in healthcare. I'm a doctor. I am. I work as a doctor. Because it's not about the ego. And a lot of doctors, especially my male colleagues,
breathing.
They think they are a doctor. But it's not being someone who does something. It's not about the job, but it's just about what you are. And you already said. So, work is not about ego. And I was really stimulated by what you said. It's not about what you're doing or don't do, but it's about feeling inside. And I think women are better in that than men. Although we don't admit, because we don't listen so much to ourselves, to our heart. And it's about the heart. It's about feel what you have to do, not because the society expects you to do something. It's about the bigger picture in life, I think. You feel something and you need to do something because you feel it. Like being in Kenya, and you know, you feel it here, that you have to do this. And I think you all will feel what you have to do. But we are all afraid to listen to that, because it's not what expected of us in society. And sometimes it's very difficult to listen to that voice, but if you listen carefully, you know what to do. And it's always about sharing that knowledge. I already know what my condition was.
Wiggle your toes, Felix. Wiggle your toes. Wiggle with your tenen.
Come on. Okay, Nelson Mandela. I love Africa. I really love it. I think if you believe in foreign lives, I was born there. I'm sure. But and for me, what Nelson Mandela does inspire is all his quotes and what he's doing. Of course, if you're sitting in a cell for 17 years in Robben Island, you think about a lot of things. You have to deal with anger, you have to deal with fear, you have to deal with everything. So that is very, listen carefully to yourself. And I think, therefore, this man became so wise. And one of his quotes is, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. And for me, education is everything. That's the reason why we're here. You educate me, I educate you. We change, exchange things, and we're making of all the dots one big circle, and that's what's all about. Women, men, it doesn't matter. So if I get inspired or I have an idea, I often look at nature, because I think nature is already telling everything about what we don't know. And for example, if you look at this picture about the bees, what can we learn from the bees? Bees live in a community, they are a population. And every bee has its role in this population. You have the queen, they have to reproduce themselves, and they have to get food, they have to fly out, get the honey, bring it back, give it to everybody, they share. There's a solidarity in the system. But when do they have the problem? The problem is when they have no food anymore. So what do they do? They have explorer bees. And the explorer bees going to fly out looking for new fields of flowers, just to bring this knowledge, go back to this population, and tells the population where it is, how far it is, which direction. Is it west, east, north, south? Everything the bee can tell. And that's I find it astonishing looking at it. But this is what you see. This is the honeybee dancing and telling the other bees where to go. So now you understand why I was dancing. I'm the explorer bee for you to to take you with me in this journey about healthcare, because that's my field. And what can we learn from the beast? Without food, the bee will extinct. So bees need explorers, otherwise they don't have food. They can't go anywhere. And there is a very strong solidarity among the bees, because they have to take care for each other. What do we have in the Netherlands? I think in the Netherlands we have a very good healthcare system, and I think we have to be proud of this healthcare system. And why is it? Because we have solidarity among every Dutch. Every Dutch can have access to very good quality of healthcare. So that's amazing. I think a lot of countries are jealous on that. But we also have a problem. We achieved to have the solidarity in the healthcare system, but nowadays we see that the costs rise, that we have also an aging problem like the rest of Europe has, mm-hmm. and now we have to take care of each other, because the solidarity in this system is under pressure. So we have to look for new fields, new flower fields, just to change that. So this healthcare, which is very precious for everybody, that we can remain in. So what are the new fields in healthcare? You have possible solutions. Like I said, I love Africa. And before I became a GP, I worked as an assistant orthopedic surgeon. So I do a lot of surgery. And the first time I went to South Africa was in 1997, and just to work in this little hospital, taking care of the community. And I was amazed by the happiness in the communities. People didn't have any money, but they were so proud, and they have so much joy, and they live day by day. But every day they were dancing and smiling, and I took a lot of those energy with me, and I think, okay, we have to learn from them also in Europe. In South Africa, there live 55 billion people, but only 9 billion of those have access to very good quality healthcare. And the rest is only, have to take care of themselves in government hospitals, which are not very good. And so there's a very big gap between rich and poor. So there's no solidarity, and that's why also this system doesn't work so much as in Holland. 2 years ago, I went to South Africa and I met two GPs. And they began a company reforming the healthcare, although it was in private healthcare, just to put a lot of things from the hospital around the GP. And so they have a lot of access to diagnostics, but there were also subacute wards. So you could admit patients easily as a GP. And also they had operation theaters for daycare. And all of this was about 50% cheaper than what the hospitals provided. And I was thinking, and I already was busy with the whole idea of this in Holland also since the beginning of my when I started as a GP, because I had a lot of knowledge of the orthopedic surgery, and I put it in the GP, and therefore I could help a lot of people just with orthopedic problems in the GP practice. But these guys already had 15 years of experience, so I was talking to them and I was thinking, oh, but this is the solution for Holland. Let's bring them to Holland and let's see if they can help us. So for me, South Africa became the field of flowers that we missed. So I was my explorer, go to South Africa, go there, and now we're just talking about starting a business in Holland, just bringing the South African system into Holland to solve our problem. In the meantime, I can be the field of flowers for South Africa, because we have this big solidarity system. So we have to bring the solidarity from Holland into South Africa. And we know that it's very difficult, especially because a lot of race problems are there. And therefore, I love Nelson Mandela because he was not looking at race, about skin color or whatever. It's about people. And I think we have to try to bring this same message again to South Africa. For me, the field of flowers in Holland, but everywhere, if you take this message, is to take care of yourself. And especially for you as women, I think it's a thing you already do. But what I noticed just in Holland, we see a lot of mothers just come to the practice with questions, easy problems, which can be solved already or used to have been solved by the grandmothers. We don't listen anymore to our grandmothers, of our ancestors. We need the knowledge of what is used to be, and we only go watching on Dr. Google and see what's happening there, and you can see all this dangerous stuff and things, and people just are afraid and want to go to the doctor just to keep them calm. And that's what I do a lot of my day. During the practice is saying that there's nothing wrong with them and that they have to listen to their grandmothers, because I think there's a lot of knowledge. So what we have to do with each other, and this is also to you, try to get the knowledge about easy care, about diseases of children, how to handle it, and bring it on. Because if we have this education to each other, you don't need the doctor for this easy care, which also doesn't cost anything, because it's only knowledge that we can share. What I bring from South Africa here is to enhance the primary care, and that we have to bring diagnostics and everything around the GP, which is much more cheaper. Also in Holland, we have made a business case, and we think we can reduce the cost of about 15%. If you look in the hospital care, the cost in Holland about 24 billion euro. If we can reduce it by the half, it means you only will spend 12 billion, and we can do it by the half of the price. So we will have savings of 6 billion, 6 how do you say a million?
Billion. Yeah. Yeah. Billion.
So it's enormous, and this all this kind of money we can invest again in the hospitals for top clinical care, but we can also reduce the cost for the healthcare. So also the poorest people also in Holland can afford to have this the healthcare and the same quality as the rich people, and that is very important. I think very important everywhere is to decrease the gap between rich and poor. Otherwise, we as men will start wars. and what I was beginning with is about the ego. We want to listen too much to our egos instead of our hearts. So that's also a thing you have to learn us. And I think if we can make the gap between rich and poor everywhere in the world a little bit smaller, you will see it have a very good prognosis of the quality of healthcare. I think it's one line. So we have to introduce a healthcare system for everybody, quality and access to this healthcare. And if this healthcare system doesn't work anymore, you have to look for other fields of flowers. So also what I did. So for me, the takeaway message is explore the world to find your fields of flowers and look at places where you don't expect it. And it can be in Kenya, it can be everywhere, because I think sometimes you have models where you didn't know, and it's not about rich and poor, it's about everywhere is nature, and we are nature, so everywhere where you will find the solutions. And to be open to sharing your knowledge, because you also can be the field of flowers for someone else. So I have a dream, equally healthcare for the world. Thank you very much.